Number 25, professional application. Consider the following question. A car moving at 10 meters per second crashes into a tree and stops in 0.26 seconds. Calculate the force the seatbelt exerts on a passenger in the car to bring him to a halt. The mass of the passenger is 70 kilograms. Would the answer to this question be different if the car with the 70 kilogram passenger had collided with a car that has a mass equal to and is traveling in the opposite direction and at the same speed? All right, so first let's just answer, let's just calculate the force here first, okay, and then we'll see what happens. So we have a car traveling to the right, has a velocity of 10 meters per second, mass of, the car doesn't have a mass, but the a person does, but remember if the car is moving at 10 meters per second, then the person is also moving at the same velocity. The mass of the person is 70 kilograms, and the time it takes for him to come to a halt is 0.26 seconds. He's going to hit a tree, and it tells us he comes to a stop. All right, so we got to calculate the force. So it sounds like his momentum is changing, right? And therefore, and also I'm given time, right? So therefore, I'm going to highlight this equation. It says that the change in the momentum is equal to the force applied multiplied by the change in time. So to find the force, just divide out delta t, right, from both sides. So this is basically the change in momentum, right, divided by the change in time will equal the force. Okay, let's expand this change in momentum. Remember, the change in momentum is always the final value minus the initial value. Okay, that's over the change in time, which also the final time minus the initial time, but they just gave us one time. I mean, we assume that it starts at zero, right, the clock. So that time is just the final time, that's fine. And that's now equal to the force. So basically, this is what I need to know in order to calculate force. Do I know the final momentum? Well, it says it comes to a stop. So what's your momentum if you're not moving? Zero, right? Why? Because look at the formula over here on the right-hand side. The momentum is equal to the mass multiplied by the velocity. If velocity is zero, your momentum is zero. So the final momentum here is going to be zero. So let's plug that in, zero. Okay, minus then the initial momentum. So that would simply be the mass of the person, which was 70 kilograms, multiplied by the initial velocity, which was 10 meters per second. Okay, that's all then divided by the time it takes for the momentum to change, which they told us was 0.26. Okay, so that will equal the force. So all we have to simply do is plug it into the calculator. So now it's negative 70 times 10, all divided by 0.26. And it looks like we get a value of about negative 2.69 times 10 to the 3 newtons. All right. Now, why is it negative? Well, remember, this is the force exerted to change an object's momentum. So if the person is going and traveling to the right, there's going to be a force applied to bring him to a halt that has to point to the left. I mean, that kind of makes intuitive sense, right? So that's why the sign here is negative. All right. And this will be the force exerted by the seatbelt because the seatbelt has to keep him from going through the windshield here. Okay, so the seatbelt's going to be exerting the force backwards. All right, so that answers that. Now, let's see what happens if we consider the second part to this question. Let's see what the answer works out to be. So now, though, instead of hitting a tree that doesn't move, and they tell us that he comes to a stop, we now have this car now going to collide with, just pretend they're the same size because they have to be for the problem. That car is moving this way. All the same characteristics. The only difference is that the velocity of that yellow car is now negative, right? Because it's moving the opposite direction. Okay? So really what I need to do is I have to find, I'm going to be using literally the same formula here. Okay? Same formula. The only difference, though, is that I don't know what the final momentum is necessarily, right? I know what his initial momentum is. That's exactly what we calculated here. That hasn't changed. But the final momentum, meaning after this collision, what is it? Well, why don't we try to calculate it, okay? Let's see what happens. So the final momentum, let's do that over here. So I'm going to use this formula now. Oops, I'm going to use this formula because now I'm not talking about him exclusively. I'm talking about this whole system, okay? So the initial momentum of that system will equal the final momentum of that system. In other words, the momentum before the collision better equal the momentum after. Okay. So the momentums before was the momentum of the first car in black plus the momentum of the second car in yellow should equal then the final momentum. Okay. So what's the momentum of the first vehicle? Well, remember it's MV, right? So it's M1, V1. The momentum of the second car, it's M2, V2. And that will equal the final, that will equal the final momentum of the system. Okay, well, let's plug in the mass of the black car and the velocity. So remember, the mass was 70 and its velocity is positive 10. The mass of the yellow car, its mass is the same thing, it's 70, and then the velocity is then minus 10. So that's going to equal the final momentum. So this works out to be 700 minus 700. And notice what happens, we get a value of 0 is equal to the final momentum. So if this whole system at the end of the collision has zero momentum, then what does he have to have as well? The driver has to have also zero momentum. So look, that zero has stayed the same. The final momentum is still zero. So remember, the initial momentum was the same. The final momentum would also be the same as I just showed you there. So the time is still the same too. So guess what's going to happen? The force is going to be exactly the same. Okay. So to answer this second part, we actually have the same force the seatbelt will exert, negative 2.69 times 10 to the 3 newtons. And by the way, you know, if you're answering this question, it doesn't tell us what direction the car is traveling in. It doesn't say, you know, the black car here that I drew is moving to the right. All right. If it did, then you must give your answer as a negative. You must give the force as a negative value. But they didn't. So I could have been free to choose the other direction. And then all of a sudden my answer would have been positive here. Okay. So, you know, when you're answering it in this case, just give the absolute value. That should be fine. Guys, thanks a lot for hanging with me. Appreciate it very much. Hope this video helped you out. And help us out too, if you could, by hitting that subscribe button. Thank you so very much for tuning in. I'll see you soon.